Hello students, welcome back to your class of English, and today we'll discuss about the sample paper which I have already provided you. As you know that we have covered our syllabus of periodic one, and these days we'll start with the revision work. And the sample paper which I have provided you contains the syllabus of periodic one. So today we'll discuss about that. The periodic one will be of 50 marks, and your sample paper as well as question paper will be of 3 sections. As the paper is divided into 3 sections A, B and C, and all the questions are compulsory. As the section A contains the reading part, and the question will be asked of reading comprehension, and the second part, that is writing skills and grammar, where you have been asked about the writing skills, that is diary entry, and the grammar of tenses and prepositions in the form of editing task and sentence reordering. And the last part is, that is C, is of literature part. So let's discuss about the solution of the sample paper. I really hope that you all have solved the paper, and you would be able to match your answers whether you have attempted corrected or not. So let's start with section A, reading. As today we'll discuss about first reading part. As we know that in 80 marks paper, reading part will be of 20 marks, and in 50 marks paper, reading part will be of 12 marks. So let's read. Read the given passage and answer the questions that follow. The name of the passage is "The Camera Can Lie Sometime." The heading, the title of the passage is "The Camera Can Lie Sometime." Much to their annoyance, pen pushers are routinely reminded that a picture is worth a thousand words. Now, this is a very common proverb, or a very common saying, that is said if we really want to emphasize the importance of the pictures, that a picture is worth than a thousand words. Excluding that, sometimes they can be wrong, but here is of the view that this quote sometimes can be wrong. Words, as happened last week when Reuters was forced to withdraw more than 900 pictures taken by a freelance photographer after it was suspected that he had doctored 2 recent photographs of the Israeli-Lebanon conflict. Here the view is given that this quote, this saying can be wrong sometimes, as something happened last week when Deuters is the name of a person, he was forced to withdraw, to take back more than 900 pictures, as these pictures were taken by freelance. Freelance is a work that is done as a part-time photographer, after it was suspected that, when it was doubted that he had doctored 2 recent photographs, that he has taken the 2 recent photographs of the Israeli-Lebanon conflict. As we know that there is a conflict, there is a fight, there is a cold war between Israeli and Lebanon for a long time. In one picture, the smoke billowing from an apartment block after an Israeli air strike was allegedly taken by the photographer Adnan Haj to dramatize the impact of the bombardment, and another 2 players were suspected to have been added to an image of an Israeli jet in action over Lebanon. In one picture, the smoke blowing from an apartment block, that the smoke was coming from an apartment block after an Israeli airstrike, as one Israeli airstrike means crashed, was allegedly thickened by the photographer. That when the smoke was coming from an apartment block, and after that the Israeli air strike was allegedly thickened by the photographer. The photographer took the pic, and the name of that was Adnan Haj. and to dramatize the impact of the bombardment. As he just taken a pic of the Israeli aircraft as it was tracked, and it was just to dramatize, just to show the impact of this bombardment, he took the pic. And in another two flares were suspected to have been added to an image. And in one, he has taken the pic of the airstrike, and another two flares. And another two flares were suspected to have been added to an image of. And in the next two flares, means two small pages, he was suspected to have been added to the image of Israeli jet in action over Lebanon. When he was just taking an action over Lebanon, against Lebanon. The allegation of doctoring first made by several bloggers was confirmed by Reuters after in-house investigation. Mr. Hodge, who had sold pictures to Reuters for more than 10 years, denied manipulating the two photographs and attributed the thick smoke in the first picture to bad lighting and the fact that he was trying to remove dust marks. As for the second, he said that there was no problem with it, not at all. The allegation of doctoring first made by several bloggers. As this allegation, blame of doctoring the pics, that first it was made by several bloggers through blogging and was confirmed by Reuters when there was the investigation in the house of Mr. Hodge. Mr. Hodge, Adnan Hodge, who had sold pictures to Reuters for more than 10 years, denied manipulating the two photographs, he rejected that he will not manipulate the two photographs that were taken of Israeli airstrike and the other one of the image of Israeli jet that was taking action over Lebanon. He will not make any changes in these two photographs, and attributed the thick smoke in the first picture, and he just added that the thick smoke that was looking or can be visible in the first picture was due to bad lighting and the fact that he was trying to remove dust marks, and he was at the time of taking the picture was just trying to remove the dust marks from the camera. As for the second, he said there was no problem with it, not at all. As in the first picture, as they were talking about the thick smoke, and he just clarified that it was happened just to the bad lighting because their camera lens was dirty, and even though he tried to remove the dust marks, but even then it was looking blurry and is showing the thick smoke. As for the second, he said there was no problem with it, not at all. But Reuters was not convinced and said that it was removing all of these pictures from his database and wouldn't be using his service anymore. But Reuters wasn't convinced. He was not satisfied with the Hodge answer, and he said that he will remove all these pictures from his data and he will not use his services in the future. This represents a serious breach of Reuters standards, and we shall not be accepting or using pictures taken by him, the news agency said. And this matter grew very serious, and they thought that it is like a break of promise from the Reuters standards. And the news agency just declared that they will not be, or in the future they shall not be accepting or using the pictures taken by the Reuters. The idea that the camera had never lies is as misleading as the notion that all statics are meant to mislead. The idea that we often commonly say that eyes don't see wrong or never tells lie, in the same way camera never tells lie, but as is a misleading, but it is somewhere wrong. As the notion, the idea that all statics are meant to mislead, because whatever the data was there, it was all about to mislead, to misguide. What the eye sees is not always what it looks like. Here again, it has been emphasized that if sometimes what we see with the eyes is not always as the way we want to look, thanks to the many ways in which the first, the camera and the photograph can be and is often manipulated. Because we can take the pic in through different angles, and finally we take the photograph as the way we want to take, and we then manipulate it. We just use it for our purpose. Indeed, a photograph can be manipulated in more ways and more effectively to convey a false reality than it is possible to do through the written words. And here it is said that the picture can be used in various ways than the written words. Ask any clever photographer and he will tell you the tricks camera be made to play. At the seminar, recently, one journalist recalled how there was a time when British photographers covering stories about famine or blood in third time countries would carry teddy bears with them in order to use them as props for pictures, supposedly showing that all the that was left in household, stricken by death and destruction, were children's toys. So at a seminar held recently, there one journalist just recalled or recapitulated that how at the time of British photographers, they're covering the stories about the famine, about the flood, about the natural calamities in the third world countries, that how could they carry teddy bears with them in order to use them as a prop for pictures only, and to pretend just that everything was left in the household and they were just stricken by death and destruction. So now let's discuss about the question that is followed by this passage.